Tudor's horrible place to live down. But what had happened, he had lost the crown to England, and he made a promise to the Pope, if I get my crown back again, I will go on a pilgrimage to Rome to say thank you. He won the throne of England back again, but the Pope said it's too dangerous to leave England, stay in England and dedicate a church to St. Peter. So that's what he did. This is the Collegiate Church of St. Peter's in Westminster. Bit of a mouthful, so we call it Westminster Abbey. Forward 200 years, we have a king called Henry III. He spends a lot of time in France. He sees that they have bigger and better churches than we do. What does he do? Comes back and builds an even bigger one than the French have. So that is why we have the Westminster Abbey of today. Started in the year 1245, built for three specific purposes: to bury our royals, to have our royal coronations, and to have a shrine dedicated to the king who comes to begin with. Crowned in this church, 39 and counting. 16 monarchs are buried here. You have been walking on people since the moment you got in here. You have 3,200 buried or commemorated, and you can walk over them, it's no problem. We're going to walk in now, just a note. Yeah, it is an active church when we go in. There will be a prayer every hour, and I'm not allowed to talk during the prayer. And the gentleman will have to ask you to remove your hat when you join the prayer.
So just from an event perspective, it's quite busy today, it's a week today.